Change of basis. We consider a continuous time linear system described by this state equation, and we propose to perform a change of basis like this, where P is an invertible and square matrix. So we have a new state vector, and there is a bijection between the new state space and the previous one. So to compute the new formulation with V, we'll perform as follows. So question number one. Since I have x dot equal ax plus bu, and y equal to cx plus du, I have the change of variable x equal to pv, or equivalently, v equal p minus yx, which is possible since p is square and invertible. As a consequence, x dot is equal to pv dot. So I take this equation and I get here pv dot equal a times x, but x is pv, plus bu. And here y equals cx, but x is pv, plus du. Now I will isolate v, and I get v dot equal p minus 1 apv plus p minus 1 bu. And here I will have the same, so y equals cpv plus du. So this is the new formulation. D has not changed, but matrix A, B, and C have changed. But the system from the input and the output are totally equivalent, u and v. Now, I take the second question. We consider a specific system like this, where there is no zeros, and we want to find a simpler representation. For instance, if it is if we have to simulate this system due to the fact that there is no zero, maybe it's interesting to change the basis to have less computation with more one and more zeros. Okay. So we propose to change of basis, and taking P, this matrix. So for the second question, I have this system, and I take for P one, 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 two, one, two, and two, one, zero. So now I will have to do this computation to compute the new matrices. So I will call it, for instance, AV, because it is in the V basis. This one will be BV, and this one will be CV. D remains the same, and in this system, there is no D, so D is equal to zero. This one does not exist. For the computation of the matrices in the V with the V basis, I will use SIMP, so I can define matrices like this: A, B, C, and P. I will print them just to check everything's okay. I will compute my matrices AV, BV, CV, and I will print them. This is a program. I run it. And I can see my matrices P, AV, BV, and CV. AV, BV, and CV. As a consequence, in the state space V, I have V dot equal, so 2100002003 V plus 2 0 minus 1 U, Y equal to 644 V. This is my system with output Y and input U. So I can see that there, the matrix A, AV, is in a Jordan form because I can see here that is not diagonal, but almost. So the eigenvalues are on the diagonal. And I may have some ones, such as this one, or zeros, but one or zero, on the diagonal just above the main diagonal. Otherwise, I have zeros everywhere. As a consequence, due to the fact that I have all these ones and zeros, the computation for a simulation is cheaper. So cheaper in energy, or also require less computation, and the cost of the circuit which makes this will be less expensive. This is why it's important to change the basis in order to have as much as possible zeros and ones. Now, I have to compute the transfer function of this system and also to compute its characteristic polynomial. To have the transfer function, I will use this Python program. I create the symbol S corresponding to the indeterminate or the Laplace variable, and I will compute the transfer function respect to V as C V S A V, excuse me, S identity minus A A V inverse times B plus D, but there is no D. I can compute with respect to the matrices in the V space, but I would obtain exactly the same result in the X space. I will simplify the expression and I will print it. So if I run it, I obtain this result given here. So equivalently, I get that G of S is equal to 12 divided by S minus 2 is 4 divided by S minus 3. Now, if I compute the characteristic polynomial of this matrix, or equivalently, or the matrix A. So the characteristic polynomial respect to AV, which is also equal to the characteristic polynomial of A, is equal, if I compute it, I will obtain S minus 2 square times S minus 3. But here, in the transfer representation, I can see the characteristic polynomial, which is equal to S minus 2 times S minus 3. So we can see that whereas we would expect a polynomial of degree 3, we have a polynomial of degree 2. This is due to a simplification between the numerator and the denominator in the simplify. So it may happen sometime, and it corresponds to the fact that some states are not observable or not controllable. Here we can see that the variable which is non-controllable is V2. Indeed, here I have 0, here I have 0, so neither x1 nor x3 has an influence on the evolution of x2. But here also I have a 0, so u is not also able to influence V2. V2 can be observed thanks to this, so has an influence on the output, but u has no effect on it. And the transfer matrix is only related to all states that are observable and controllable. And this is why I have a simplification somewhere. It is due to the fact that this does not appear inside the transfer representation. It is possible to see here quite easily in the Jordan form, but it was much more difficult to see this in the initial representation that we are given here.